Welcome to WARN, South Asian leaders pat Modi for gifting satellite to the region. Taking both space diplomacy and India's outreach to the neighbors into a new orbit, Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed a unique joint video conference of the leaders of all SAARC countries, apart from Pakistan, who had declined to join the South Asia satellite program, shortly after the successful launch of the GSLV GSAT. The South Asia satellite demonstrates that our collective choices for our citizens will bring us together for cooperation, not conflict, development, not destruction, and prosperity, not poverty, Mr. Modi told the leaders on the video conference, including Afghanistan President Ashraf Ghani, Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, Bhutan PM Tshering Tobgay, Maldives President Abdulla Yameen, Nepal Prime Minister Pushpa, Kamal, Dahal Prachanda, and Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena. Ambassadors of all six nations were also invited to witness the lift-off at ISRO's Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. The video conference, which had not been declared prior to the event, was announced by PM Modi as a surprise barely moments after he congratulated ISRO scientists for the successful launch on Twitter. The support and presence of these leaders will add even more joy in the hearts and minds of our region, Mr. Modi said, adding, "We are a united family of South Asian countries, united in our pursuit of peace, progress and prosperity of our region and the entire humankind." Speaking by turn, the other leaders congratulated India for its technological success, as well as Mr. Modi personally for turning his vision to reality by seeing the Rs 450 crore launch through. "I am grateful to PM Modi and the people of India for the very special gift to the South Asian region, and compliment the PM and India's visionary neighborhood first policy," said Maldivian President Yameen. "The launch of the South Asia satellite is historic for the world, as this is the first time a country has launched a satellite for the free use of its neighbors," added Bhutan PM Tshering Tobgay, calling it an impressive milestone in regional cooperation. Nepal's PM particularly noted the satellite's role in developing communications in his country's mountainous and remote areas. Both Bangladesh PM Hasina and Sri Lankan President Sirisena also praised the potential uses of the GSLV GSAT in meeting developmental needs in the areas of telemedicine, teleeducation, banking and television Q-band broadcasting opportunities. Mr. Modi had proposed the plan for the shared satellite as a gift to the neighborhood, during the SAARC summit in Kathmandu in 2014. However, after Pakistan pulled out of the project, it was called the South Asia satellite rather than the SAARC satellite. Pakistan Ministry of Foreign Affairs spokesman Nafees Zakaria said the country was initially keen to participate in the project, but claimed India was not willing to develop the project on a collaborative basis. Referring to Pakistan's refusal to also join India's proposal of a SAARC motor vehicle agreement that had stopped Afghanistan from being linked to it, Afghan President Ghani said in his address on the video conference that if cooperation through land is not possible, it is certainly possible through sky, and we are confident that South Asia will integrate. The successful launch is seen as a success for both the government's declared objective of working with SAARC countries minus Pakistan if it refused to cooperate, as well as an important step in South Asian connectivity just ahead of the major Belt and Road Forum in China that India is staying out of, but other South Asian countries have joined. "This launch tells us that even the sky is not the limit when it comes to regional cooperation," PM Modi said as he thanked the leaders for joining him in the celebration of the GSLV launch. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.